everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and look at the temperature today.
This is February 22nd.
Right. This is unheard of weather for this season, this part of the country during this time of the year.
Oh, think of all the people who plan their winter escapes to Florida, to Southern California,
right,
to the Gulf Coast, just to enjoy 70, 80 degree weather. How about our snow?
We have no snow. Now, we will have some snow at the end of the week. Right now, it's Wednesday. We're supposed to have snow on Saturday, and it's supposed to get down to more natural, normal temperatures by Saturday.
33 degrees?
But it's supposed to reach 70 today. Now, this little thermometer has been sitting in the sun.
Yeah, but it was 65 when I took it off the wall.
I know. To us, it's like 80 degrees out, because here we are at the end of February in short, skinny little clothing.
How come you're not wearing your flip-flops?
Really? We have seen people in shorts and flip-flops. It's not that they aren't there. They are definitely running around with tank tops and shorts and flip-flops, and it's like the beach. But we just wanted to take a little walk around the yard and show you things that are sprouting that, you know, we normally wouldn't see sprouting at this time, but because of all these temperatures being so high, they are sprouting. And we also wanted to make sure that if you are in this freeze zone, don't start uncovering your perennials. In fact, if you have things that you can put on them, more leaves, straw, something, continue to keep them covered if at all possible, because if it rains and freezes, it's the crown of the perennial that will be damaged by that. Not so much the freezing and thawing at this point, but it's the crown being frozen by either rain that suddenly turns to ice, or, you know, just some freaky thing. They're still supposed to be asleep, so pretend they are, and don't get all excited and say, oh, I'm going to go out and clean off my flower beds. Don't do it yet.
Well, think of this Japanese maple here.
Yes.
One of the reasons people have trouble growing them is because of the constant thawing and freezing, and they don't like that. And this area normally is one of the last areas to be covered with snow, or have snow melt, I should say. So it's in a little alcove here, and
the ground under here is still frozen.
Yeah.
In some of the places in the yard, it is starting to unfreeze, the ground that is. And as of even 2 days ago, you couldn't stick like a lamppost or a stick into the ground. It was frozen not even an inch below.
Well, now, you guys pulled out the trumpet vine yesterday. I was amazed you could dig it out.
We could, but that's on the south where the sun beats down on it all day. That's not in the shade at all. So with a hefty shovel and some vigorous energy, we were able to get that trumpet vine out.
Well, you also had some flowers that were blooming last week already. Let's go take a look at those.
Some flowers. Those very flowers were blooming at the beginning of February. These are called the sub-zero pansies, and you plant them in the fall, and they will come up early in the spring, even in the snow, and flower. And there is one of them right there.
That is amazing. Plus you had a yellow one.
I did, and a peach colored one.
Yeah.
But they are really tough little plants. Now, I don't know that they're gonna even make it through the summer. I don't know their lifespan. This is the first time we ever planted these, so we're not familiar with them. We only know that you plant them in the fall and they blossom early in the spring. So we'll see.
Well, your irises are coming up already, obviously. They
yes.
never really totally went down this
no,
year.
Not all of them. Nope. They didn't. A plant that stays green all winter is the burrow's tail. It's a succulent plant. This blooms early in the spring, or I should say early summer, but it stays green like this all winter. The thing is, we normally wouldn't see it because this would be under snow that we've shoveled off of the driveway. So usually it's covered with a pile of snow, and we don't actually see it, but they are coming out all along the edge of the driveway. And then we look down and we see this foxglove. Now, I don't know that this actually ever totally got browned out, or if it stayed green, especially at the roots. Again, we wouldn't see this except that there's no snow here. So you're able to see it. I'm trying to see what this is right here. Oh, these look like snapdragons.
Yeah.
That seeded themselves. Now I'm sure they're going to seed themselves again because they were very happy about living there. And look at this. This is a daisy. Now these daisies move themselves around the yard, and again they are one of the first that turn green. Again, we wouldn't be seeing these. They'd be piled under snow. But they're showing now. We have often shown this little spot where the moss loves to grow. It's on an old maple tree that we took out, and it's blossoming. Those are the blossoms of the moss.
Those little red
tufts. Those little stalks there. They are, it's already blossoming. Moss is really tough. I mean, look at this, it's growing on a brick.
That is amazing. And this we never planted here. This is just something that developed
right.
Itself.
Yep. On the south side of the house, where it gets sun all the time, the lavender is doing lovely. You would think this is the middle of summer for that lavender.
And then next to it?
And then next to it is spiderwort, which is coming up just like it's supposed to, but too early. Again, this would have been under snow that had been shoveled off the sidewalk and piled here. So we're enjoying it now.
No snow.
No snow.
Hey, no shoveling.
Also on the south side of the house, we have the sedum that just creeps everywhere once you put it in. This is a type of
goldenrod,
yes, a perennial goldenrod that I'll just try to cover back up again a little bit. And underneath here, daffodils.
Yeah, look at all those in there.
Here they come.
It's amazing.
Yep. We were at a workshop, a garden workshop this weekend. And the first question that the expert told us was, people are concerned about the daffodils coming up, or the tulips coming up, and all these things. And he said, the plants are adaptable. They're used to being different in different weather each year. So he said, don't worry too much about them. They'll be fine. So, I mean, if they come up and they freeze, then later on we'll see burnt off leaf tips, but
well, look at your rhododendrons in the background.
Rhododendrons are nice and green. Again, those would have been covered with snow at this point because, again, we shovel, we pile it, particularly on top of those rhododendrons, just to protect them from the freezing and thawing again. Their buds are getting larger and larger.
Well, they even recommended getting bags of ice and just drizzling it around the base of the rhododendrons just to keep
yes.
that soil cooler.
Right, so that it stays in the frozen state rather than the thawing and the freezing. Also, if you've planted new little conifers, put ice on the around the ground just to keep them colder until the cold weather comes back again.
How about the little surprises in your garden area?
Oh,
let's go take a look at those. Yeah.
Yes. Some of you may know from past videos that we have this thing about tree peonies. And for years, we have planted seeds and tried to get them to grow. And some of them did. And over the years, the ones that did grow are getting larger and larger. Last year we had two that blossomed, yep. And this year we're going to get more because here's our little babies, and they have nice big buds on them.
You can just see there, all
there.
Over.
Yeah. Yep.
I mean, they're hard to distinguish right now amongst all the leaves and everything, but they are amazing. And you can tell what colors they are too.
Yes.
Like this one over here, as an example, is definitely going to be red.
Yes.
So a lot of buds on those.
Right.
It'll be interesting to see. I mean, we've had trouble with the rabbits taking them down to the ground. So.
Right. And the voles and the mice, when we first planted them, got in and chewed them out from the bottom. So these are the strong, hardy ones that have made it through all that turmoil. And you can see we still have the leaves on them. We're not taking the leaves off. Also with our garlic, we have lots of garlic planted.
And it's behaving itself.
Right, a couple had started popping up in the fall before we mulched, and then we mulched them really heavily, so they are still down there where they belong. We also have our lemon lilies coming up right around the base of the tree. Those blossom on Memorial Day weekend. So that's May. That's months away. But here they are starting because of the warmth again.
Well, how about your poppies?
Poppies are staying out down where they belong. But
yeah, but they're green.
Yeah, they are. I shouldn't say they're staying down where they belong.
No.
You're right. Look at them.
I know.
Get back under there.
And what is this?
Those are coral bells.
Oh yeah.
Coral bells are tough. They will stay green. More. And daffodils. Daffodils are tough. And there they come.
Looks like this batch already this year is gonna have to be divided.
There. Yes.
Nice and tight. There's yep. more groups over there.
Right. Yes.
I see you have a poppy that's coming up over next to that log over there.
Go back to sleep.
Amazing.
It's too early. So all these hints of spring are coming along. Reality is going to show up this weekend. But
enjoying it in the meantime.
And it looks like maybe it'll be a early spring, but who knows? We'll just have fun while it's here.
So you're going to put your swimsuit on today and bask in the sun?
No.
Why not?
No. Thank you, no. If you enjoyed this video and would like to support our Wisconsin Garden Blog, please give us a thumbs up. I know some of you have told us what's coming up in your garden. Let us know if anything's blooming too. We'd love to know that. If you'd like to send a comment or question, wonderful. If you'd like to become part of our garden family, please subscribe. We'd love to have you. Thank you so much for watching. We appreciate it.
So what are you going to do now?
Oh,
you want to take a walk?
Walk, yes, while it's sunny and warm.
I know. Let's go do it.
Okay.
Quit lollygagging.
Connect with us on YouTube.